إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، verily all praise and thanks belongs unto Allah. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask for His aid, help, and assistance, and for His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and from the mischief of our bad deeds. Verily, those whom Allah has guided, there is none who can lead them astray. And those who are led astray, you will never find for them anyone who will be a guide. I publicly testify and bear witness that nothing has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah alone without any partners. And I publicly testify and bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the slave and messenger of Allah. As to what follows, O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and do not die except that you are Muslim. O humanity, fear your Lord who created you from a single soul, and from that soul He created His mate, and from them too He made many men and women. So fear Allah through whom you demand your mutual rights, and do not cut off relations with the wombs that bore you. Indeed, Allah is an ever watcher over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say a word that is truthful, straightforward, and direct. If you do this, Allah will rectify for you your deeds and forgive you for your sins. And verily, the one who has obeyed Allah and His Messenger, then they have already achieved a great achievement. As to what follows, indeed, the most truthful speech and the best speech is the Book of Allah. And the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the worst of all affairs are newly invented matters in the religion. Because every newly invented matter in the religion is bid'ah. Every bid'ah is a going astray. And every going astray is in the hellfire. Alhamdulillah ala ni'mati al-Islam wa sunnah. All praise and thanks belong unto Allah for guiding us to Islam and for guiding us to the sunnah. Ya ibadullah, we continue reflecting and going over the tremendous book by Imam Ibn Qayyim, which was a letter in which he sent to one of his brothers. In reflecting on the last portion of the statement of Imam Ibn Qayyim, so that we better understand how it connects to today's lesson and today's portion of this tremendous letter, Imam Ibn Qayyim, he had mentioned the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَجَعْلَنِي مُبَارَكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُ, and he made me blessed, what translated means, and he made me blessed wherever I may be, as it comes in Surah Maryam. What this means is, and this was Allah Ta'ala, he was informing us of what Isa ibn Maryam, he mentioned, and he made me blessed wherever I may be, meaning that Allah Ta'ala, he made Isa one who was blessed wherever he was. What is meant by that is a mu'alliman lil khair, that he was one who called the people to good and taught them good. Da'iyan ila Allah, he called the people to Allah, to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And undoubtedly this was the da'wah of Isa ibn Maryam. This was the da'wah of Isa alayhi salatu wassalam. He called the people to worship Allah and Allah alone. He did not call the people to worship him and his mother and saints and things of this nature. No. But he called the people to La ilaha illallah, to worship Allah and to worship Allah alone, without associating any partners with him in worship. To make one's religion, one's life and one's everything sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ala kulli hal, he goes on to mention what is meant by blessed wherever he may be. Mudhakkiran bihi, that he reminds people about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He reminds people to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muraghiban fi ta'atihi, and he encourages them to be obedient unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These were the characteristics of Isa ibn Maryam and of his da'wah, and how he was blessed wherever he was, because wherever he was a source of benefit. This is not something that is restricted to Isa ibn Maryam, but anyone who has these characteristics, then they will have a piece of this blessing. And this is why Imam Ibn Qayyim, he said, وَهَذَا مِنْ بَرَكَةِ الرَّجُلِ, and this is from the blessings of an individual, of a man. وَهَذَا فَهَذَا مِنْ بَرَكَةِ الرَّجُلِ. نعم, this is from a man's benefit, a man's blessing, is that if you will find that this individual, he will be blessed wherever he may be. Meaning that he will be one who, he is teaching the people good. He is one who is calling unto Allah, reminding the people to remember Allah and make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is one who is encouraging the people to be obedient unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and by default discouraging them from the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If a person does this, then a person is blessed. Imam Ibn Qayyim, he goes on to mention, he says, وَمَنْ خَلَى مِنْ هَذَا فَقَدْ خَلَى مِنَ الْبَرَكَةِ. He said, and whoever is devoid of this, then they are devoid of blessing. And he says, وَمُحِقَتْ بَرَكَةُ لِقَائِهِ وَاجْتِمَاعِهِ بَلْ تُمْحَقُ بَرَكَةُ مَنْ لَقِيَهُ وَاجْتَمَعَ بِهِ فَإِنَّهُ يُضَيِّعُ الْوَقْتَ فِي الْمَجَارَيَاتِ نعم وَيُفْسِدُ الْقَلْبِ. So this individual, you will find that there is no blessing. Blessings have been removed and are deficient from meeting with him and from gathering with him. Rather, the one who meets with him, you will find that the blessings will be deficient for that individual due to the meeting with him and gathering with him, meaning the time that they are with him, then they too will lose out on blessings. Why? Because this individual wastes his time. They waste time talking about this and that. Al-majarayat. Naam, this is this and that. This thing happened, that thing happened, so on and so forth. Inshallah ta'ala, we come back to it, the meaning of that word. But this is the gist of it. They waste his time talking about just this and that, frivolous things that have no benefit. And they corrupt the heart. They bring corruption to the heart. Now, this is the reality. So we want to reflect on this, bi'ithnillahi ta'ala, and start to reflect on the likes of these sittings and how these sittings are of no benefit. Now, and also contemplate and go into what Imam Ibn Qayyim mentions here. So, Sheikh Sulaiman al-Ruhaini, hadhallahu ta'ala, he mentions, he says, أي من خلا من تعليم الخير بالقدوة والكلمة الطيبة والنصيحة فقد خلا من البركة. He says, so the one who they are devoid from teaching the people good, either by being a good example, or by a word of good, or by giving advice, sincere advice. So this person is not a good example. They do not set a good example. They do not speak good and give good words, calling the people to what is correct, nor do they give sincere advice. Then this individual is devoid of barakah. They're devoid of blessings. Naam. But listen. ما معنى فقد خلا من البركة? What does it mean that they are devoid of blessings? Naam. هل يعني أنه يخلو من البركة مطلقا? Does this mean that they have no blessings whatsoever? Is that the meaning of it? That they are devoid of blessing to the point where they have no blessings whatsoever? نقول لا. Then we say no. This is not what it means. Devoid here of blessings, it does not mean that they have absolutely no blessings. Meaning that is what is intended by the statement of Imam Ibn Qayyim when he said that they are devoid. Meaning that they are devoid of blessings from this standpoint, but they have other blessings. Okay, so they're not devoid in totality, but as relates to this topic, okay, they have no portion of it. But they have other blessings. So the Shaykh says, نقول لا. We say no. They have blessings. المسلم ما دام أنه مسلم ففيه بركة الإسلام. نعم. So a Muslim, as long as he's a Muslim, then he has the blessing of Islam, a blessing of being a Muslim. So he's still blessed. The Muslim is always blessed, period. نعم. He says, ولكن المقصود, but what is intended here, فقد خلا من البركة الظاهرة النافعة. He says it means that this individual is devoid of the blessings that are apparent and that could be clearly seen, yani apparently, upon a person. إن كان فيه بركة ففي نفسه, يعني فهي في نفسه. If he has, يعني he has بركة, but that بركة is in himself. It only benefits himself is in himself. أما البركة الظاهرة النافعة فقد خلا منها. But as far as the blessings that are apparent and are clear, then he is devoid from blessings from this standpoint. أو أن المقصود قد خلا من البركة في هذا مجلس الذي لم يعلم فيه الخير. Or what is meant is he is devoid from blessings in this specific sitting. When they are in that sitting, he is devoid of blessing because he is not teaching the people that sitting in which they are not teaching the people with good. So there is no blessings for him inside of that sitting. نعم. فالذي لا يعلم الناس الخير. So the one who does not teach the people good when they are in gatherings and the likes of this nature. And remember when we said that teaching the people good doesn't necessarily just mean that you're saying a kalima, that you're saying a word or you're saying anything. It could be by your manners. It could be by setting an example. Let me give you an example of this. Now, and this was something that I experienced with some of the mashaykh and the ulama when I sat with them and I ate with them. Sheikh Usama Al-Umri, حفظه الله تعالى, he is an individual, he is a man of the sunnah. Naam, he's a man of the sunnah. And he is a great teacher. Even in situations where you may not necessarily expect a lesson to be appropriate to be given there, he gives a lesson, but not in the form of words. We were eating with him, and as the people finished eating, he looked to them, and I was sitting across from him, and I didn't take a large portion of food, so I was the first to finish. And we had muluchiya. And muluchiya, it is a dish that it leaves behind a residue, right? It's like a, I don't know how to explain it really, but it is a dish, and you know, when you're done eating, you'll still see traces of it on the plate. For the West Indian, it's almost like kalaloo. Now, for West Indian people who know, it's almost like kalaloo, okay? So it's something like this. So it leaves behind, you know, you can finish eating it, but you still see traces of it on the plate. So when I had finished from my portion, the Sheikh, he looked at me, and we had bread, we had khubs, and the ish baladi we had, right? So the Sheikh, he looked at me and he said, are you going to leave it like that? Right? And I said, no, Sheikh, I'm going, you know, I was reaching for a piece of bread. I said, I'm going to lap up what is left with the bread. So I did that, and he said, "That is good. That is good." And then by doing this, this was what? A lesson for all that was in attendance. Why? He was reminding us to never leave behind any barakah, because the barakah that's placed inside of the food, you don't know where it's at. So clean the plate. And as we know, it is from the sunnah to clean the plate and to lick the plate, and for one to lick their fingers when they are done, to get all of the pieces of the food that Allah Ta'ala, He has provided you with, and to not disregard and deem as little and insignificant anything, and to not be wasteful, right? So just by that small word, him looking and being very attentive at what at the people who were eating and asking that simple question, the Sheikh, he taught a great lesson and reminded us of a great lesson and a piece of the aspect from the Sunnah that we should be implementing. So this is an example of this, right? So now let's say you are in a city and you're eating with the people. You can do the same thing without even saying a word, without even asking, "Are you done?" or anything like this. But you can do the same thing by simply taking your plate, taking the bread, wiping it clean, and then licking the plate, and then licking your fingers. The people around, because this is something that is has a sunnah has been abandoned, they're going to take notice to it. They're going to take notice to it. And for those who are familiar with the narration, it might remind them, and then they'll do it. For those who are not familiar, they may ask you, "Why are you doing that?" And then now you could explain. And if that's all they got and they left with, alhamdulillah, they were reminded of a sunnah that many people have forgotten. That is barakah. That is blessing that was in that sitting. You see? And this is just an example. There are many things you can do like this. This is just an example where you can be an example to people, or you can say a small word to them. You don't have to give a whole dars. You can give a small word to them that will be of great and tremendous benefit. Ala kulli hal, I hope this is helpful so that we can use it in our day-to-day life, inshallah ta'ala. So ala kulli hal, going back, okay? Going back. So another meaning of what could be understood from that is a void of barakah, meaning that this particular sitting, there is no barakah in the sitting. So the first one is that the man has no barakah himself, the individual, no barakah that is apparent. He only has the barakah, he only has the blessing that is in himself because he's Muslim, or in herself because she is Muslim, right? Another meaning also is in the specific sitting, there is no barakah in that sitting because there is no teaching being done, no reminding being done, no encouraging people to be obedient to Allah, so on and so forth. Now, the sitting is devoid of the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so there is no what? There's no barakah in that sitting. Why? Because they are wasting time. They're wasting time talking about majarayat. Majarayat, this is, the Shaykh goes on to mention, al-umur al-jariya. You know, things that are going on, current events, things going on. Hey, you see this, you see that. Did you see in this post, whatever? Nam, jara kether wa kether, this happened, that happened. Hasala kether wa kether, this took place, that took place. Yani waqa'a kether wa kether, you know, this sparked up over there, and this did happen over there, so on and so forth. Mimma yudayu al-waqt, from those things that really waste time. You know, somebody saying, "Oh yeah, do you see that thing on social media? These two people are in a beef and they're going at one another. Did you see what was going on and stuff like that?" That's a waste of time. It doesn't benefit no one in anything. In fact, it may even be a source of sin, because you may now encourage somebody to go and, you know, dig more deeper into that situation. Now they're listening to all kind of music and this and that, and a'udhu billah, you know, and search yourself up for some loss. So yeah, that's really a loss right there. That's really a loss. As the young folks say, that's a big L. You caught an L with that one. Ala kulli hal. Now, the Sheikh goes on, he says, وَلَا يَعُودُ عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ بِالْخَيْرِ. That it does, this type of sitting, it does not bring to the individual any type of good. Huh? Does not bring to him any type of good. وَقَدْ يَكُونُ فِي مَجْلِسِهِ مَا يُفْسِدُ الْقَلْبِ. But rather, it may even be in the majlis that which will corrupt the heart. أو يقصيه, or something that will harden the heart. وعياذ بالله. ولهذا جاء في الحديث الذي صححه الألباني وحسنه الوادعي رحمهم الله جميع. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من قوم يقوم من مجلس لا يذكرون الله فيه إلا قاموا عن مثل جيفة حمار وكان لهم حسرة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, what translated means, there is no sitting where the people gather and they do not remember Allah. There's no sitting where the people gather and they do not remember Allah inside of it, except that it is like they have gotten, like when they're done, it's like they have gotten up from the carcass of a donkey. Naam? So any sitting like that, you get up from it, it's like getting up from sitting around the carcass of a dead donkey. Okay, you understand? You get it? Okay? And it is something that will be a source of great regret. That's the reality of the situation. Sheikh Suleiman Ruhaili, he goes on to mention, he says, فَمَا مِنْ قَوْمٍ يَجْلِسُونَ مَجْلِسًا لَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ فِيهِ إِلَّا قَامُوا عَنْ مِثْلِ جِيفَةِ الْحِمَارِ فَأَيُّ بَرَكَ فِي هَذَا. Eh? فَأَيُّ بَرَكَ فِي هَذَا. Where's the blessing in this? Where's the blessing about sitting around a dead donkey? If a dead donkey was there and is rotten and the maggots is crawling inside of it, and you know, the eyes have sunken in because they've been eaten and all that and this stuff like this, and the vultures and that started to pick from it, is rotten and is decaying, and we say, yo, let's sit around this donkey. You're gonna say, no, there's no blessing in that. Okay, a majlis, a sitting, a gathering that is devoid from the remembrance of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is like sitting around a dead donkey. It's not a place you want to be. Okay. So the Shaykh, he says, "Hey, you baraka fi hadha." Like, where's the blessing in that? Sitting around a dead donkey. Wa kana hasra, and it's going to be a source of regret. Alayhim yawm al-qiyamah, is going to be a source of regret upon them on the day of judgment. Ya'ni law lam yaqa'u fi ithm, and this is if they don't even fall into sin. It's going to be a source of regret even if there's no sin inside of this sitting. Li'annahum yarawna al-hasanat yawm al-qiyamah وَيَنْدِمُونَ أَنَّهُمْ لَمْ يَكْتَسِبُوا فِي مَجْلِسِهِمْ ذَلِكَ الْحَسَنَاتِ. Because they're going to see the deeds in the day of judgment when the deeds are being weighed. They're going to see the deeds and they're going to be regretful that they did not take advantage and put forth good deeds during that opportunity. So now this portion of their life is devoid. No good deeds did they earn in that hour or two or whatever, however long that they sat with in that sitting that was devoid of remembrance of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. They're going to regret that time that they did not remember Allah and take advantage and do good deeds so they can have more good deeds. So it's going to be a source of regret on the day of judgment, even if no sin happened therein. Okay, so I want you to remember that, because people will come and say, but we didn't make any sin, we're not doing nothing haram. Naam. We're not doing nothing haram. Dimish haram. It's not haram. Okay. You didn't do anything haram, but you're not doing anything to benefit yourself at the same time as well. You're not doing anything to strengthen and to multiply and to, yani, you know, aid your good deeds on the day of judgment. You're not bringing forth any good deeds in this time. You're not doing anything to do good deeds. So you're not earning any good deeds at the time. Okay, it's not haram, but you're not helping yourself. So now you're in a situation, let's break it down and make it simple. You're in a situation where, yes, you're not hurting yourself, but you are not helping yourself. So the person is going to be regretful. For them 2 hours, whatever, I didn't help myself by putting forth good deeds. فَمَجْلِسْ أَلَّذِي لَا يُذْكَرُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَ فِيهِ مَمْحُقْ الْبَرَكَ. So the majlis where Allah Ta'ala, he is not remembered therein, that it is devoid of blessing. The Shaykh, he goes on to say, وَيَنْبَغِي عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ أَنْ يَحْذَرَ مِنْ مُجَالِسَةِ مَنْ لَا يُذَكِّرُهُ بِاللَّهِ. He says, so a person, he has to be very wary of sitting with people who do not remind him of Allah. So the majalis, the barakah, is in the remembrance of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. So we should strive to be of those who constantly remind people to remember Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, to bring good to them, by teaching them and advising them, either by setting a good example, so you don't say anything but you set a good example, or by saying a good word unto them and advising them, so on and so forth. This is how we have to be, because these are the majalis that are good. So now I want you to think and reflect about your sittings with your family. Apply this when it comes to sitting with your family. Make it a sitting that is good, where you're advising them, where you are talking to them in a good manner to make them happy. Because making a Muslim happy is a good deed. Huh? Making a Muslim happy is a good deed. Smiling at them is a good deed. That's sadaqah. So, husbands and wives should be smiling at one another for no reason, right? To bring joy into them. You smile, they smile. This is a very good thing. So we should increase and think about all of these good deeds that we can do and we can bring forward. Like I said, it's not always just a word or something, no. You can just smile at your brother. Now your brother feels good. He smiles back at you. It's from the sunnah to smile. This is a good deed. You brought joy to his heart. That's a good deed. You understand? We have to constantly be striving to do good deeds. We have to be always on the lookout for good deeds and avoid those sittings where the people are not on the lookout for good deeds. فنكتفي بهذا القدر وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وجزاكم الله خيرا.